don't want Jewish people to stop being Jewish. And that's something that the church needs to know. Most people, most evangelicals, in good faith, they believe that the place for a Jew, once he becomes a believer, is to stop being Jewish and become a good Baptist, good Presbyterian, good Methodist. It will never happen. A Jew will always be a Jew. So that's something that the church has needed to know, that we're not trying to bring people to the church. We're trying to bring people to the knowledge of Jesus. If later on they want to join a church, praise the Lord. If they want to attend a Messianic congregation, praise the Lord. But what the church needs to know, that important thing, is to present the gospel to the Jewish people.
There is a Messianic movement that is growing, and the reason why it's growing is people are going back to the early church practices. Jews and Gentiles alike want to go back to basic practices of the first century that were biblical. That's before you had Christmas. That's before you had Easter. That's before you had some of these traditions that came in the third and fourth centuries and then became anchored in the church, often at the expense of the biblical practices, celebrating the feasts and remembering some of the major events that took place in Israelite history.
The unspoken fear among many Jews is the consequence of having your family reject you, your community reject you, of being thought of as someone who has left the fold. And so for me, I have a community. Not the community I grew up with, unfortunately. Most of them have not accepted Jesus as the Messiah. But for the Jews that I do connect with, there are Jews who are believers in Jesus as well. And we have a community amongst ourselves. And I think when seekers look into that community, they recognize the difference.
There is a presence of Jewish believers throughout the last 2,000 years. We can find evidence here and there of some of the Christian saints of the Catholic Church were Jewish. And so there were always Jewish believers over the centuries who understood that Jesus was the Messiah, the Jewish Messiah. And so they became Messianic Jews, if we want. And so now, with what's been happening in the last 20 years, in the last 20 years, 30 years, 40 maybe, and the rise of the Messianic movement around the world, it's God's plan. And I think our place is to come and walk with them and stand with them and continue to reach the Jewish people.
There's a huge opportunity to present a form of acceptance to Jewish people who have a Christian parent and a Jewish parent, or from a mixed marriage, because you're not accepted in the traditional Jewish world as being Jewish if you don't have a Jewish mom. And so I think there's, you know, thousands of Jews out there who don't know, don't really completely feel like they're Jewish, but they do appreciate their Jewishness, and so we can present to them a opportunity to be accepted within the Messianic community as being Jewish.
And my prayer still is to be able to expose Gentile leaders to the importance of the Messiah being Jewish, his family being Jewish, his ancestry, his history, and everything that he brought to the table. Because usually in the church, church leaders don't think about Jesus in Jewish terms. And so this is something that needed to be put on the table, discussed in many different ways through Messianic Jewish theology, through biblical studies, and really New Testament, Old Testament, and really get Gentile leaders or future leaders to get aha moments of, wow, we've missed them. We've missed that in the church.
One of the things that we've seen, particularly in the last, decade, and particularly in the last 3 or 4 years, is that we are seeing that more and more Jewish people are open to the gospel. We are seeing a younger generation that they are not only open to the gospel, but they are being converted. In our own congregation, I think the last 4 or 5 years, the average age of those who've been converted is probably about 22 or 23. Some of these are second generation, those who have grew up in a messianic home, in a Jewish Christian home. Others come from a secular, we have one Orthodox man that was converted and baptized. So we are seeing the both. But what is really encouraging is to see that not only these young people who are coming to faith, but they have a great zeal of sharing their faith with their colleagues, whether in school, whether it's in the military particularly, or whether it's other places. And that's a great encouraging to see these young people, because we see not only a hope for the church in the future, but we are also seeing something that I believe is the first fruit of the promises of God in Romans 11, that one day all Israel shall be saved. We are starting to see a flow of that, something that we have not seen before.